In this picture, we can see a bunch of people heading to some kind of shelter. We can clearly understand that they are refugees, not only by the fact that they carry with them some bags with essential things, but mainly by the expression of pain in their faces. I think this photo was taken pretty recently because this phenomenon is rising quickly, especially in my country, where refugees from Syria arrive every day in crowded groups. Once I look at this picture, I get really keen feelings. I mostly feel compassion for these people. I sympathize with their pain, and I really hope they find their way to a better life. They have been through a lot. They felt rejection and power forms of racism. They deserve their established right to a dignified life, and no one can deprive it from them. Most people will interpret this picture with sadness and commiseration, but there is always another side of the coin. Some people may feel pleasure by looking at those people pain. Those people probably haven't received proper education, and they can react with only acts of racism. I really like this picture, even though it gives me some negative feelings. What I mostly like about it, is its spontaneity. It looks pretty real, and because of that, people can understand how these refugees really feel and how much pain they have been through.
I see that how some innocent people are killed due to some social problems, which means we don't respect human beings. Also, I see the love and respect between humans. People have left some flowers, photos, flags, and many more things. And I see the two people that hug each other. After they see all of that in front of Bataclan coffee shop. I think that the photo was taken a day after the terrorist attack. I feel sad for all those people who lost their lives and their families for the emotional pain that they go through. Other people can probably feel sad and disappointed. Maybe they think we live in a world full of crime and cruelty. In the picture, I like all the flowers that people have left for their loved ones, and I don't like that there were only two people in the photo.
I see a huge chariot with the Prime Minister of Great Britain on top of it, and the Prime Minister is wearing the national colours of Britain. And she's trying to commit suicide with a gun that says Brexit. The picture was taken a little while before or after the decision on the British referendum upon Brexit. I feel as if the British citizens have regretted the decision on Brexit, and they try to show to the world that the results of the referendum will be crucial for Britain. People might think that the Britons feel unsure about their decision to leave the Eurozone. I like the fact that even though the whole picture looks kind of pessimistic, there's a good luck Great Britain under the chariot.
In this picture, I can see a group of people with they are from different countries, probably standing there after a meeting and pretend they are feeling okay and they're fine. This photo was taken before or after a meeting that they had, probably for some things they had to decide. When I look at this picture, I don't really feel something because some of the people, I don't even know them, and I can have a certain feeling about them. When people see at this picture, most of them, they are not going to feel nothing because they don't know the people that they're studying in this photo, and they obviously don't care about them of many reasons. In this picture, I don't like the fact that they are studying right there, one to another, and it feels like it's pretending it. They don't seem like they are happy, they just stand there and do nothing. And I don't really like the fact that they are only 20 people that have to decide their life and